What's up, everybody? My name is Jeremy Jones, and I am back with another video. Today, we're talking Supreme selling for $2.1 billion. So stay tuned.
Changing in my life, hoping one day I'ma get it all right. Brother is engaged, about to start a new life. Yeah, I haven't had a chill day, really wanna vibe, appreciate the moments. I've been creating, not scrolling. Mom and dad still supporting.
All right, man, we're back with another video, man. Before I get too deep into this video, y'all already know what to do. Go and hit that like button, it really helps the channel out. And if you're new, consider subscribing. I make content about sneakers. All right, so let's dive in today's video, right? We're talking Supreme selling for $2.1 billion. Man, all right, so first things first, man, if you're not familiar with Supreme, I used to make videos on copping Supreme like way back in the day, like a couple years ago. I haven't really copped Supreme in a minute because I just really haven't been feeling their style, man. But at the same time, if y'all been keeping up with me and you're like an OG subscriber, y'all already know off rip I'm very big into skateboarding. Supreme is a skateboarding brand, even though the owner of Supreme, the originator who created Supreme, has been known as not being a skateboarder. He just really was fascinated by the culture, right? Okay, so anyway, needless to say, you know, if you're following the, you know, sneaker world, and a part of the sneaker world comes with the streetwear, and of course you can't talk streetwear without talking Supreme, right? Okay, let's just keep it 100. But with that being said, recently Supreme has sold for $2.1 billion, right? Okay, that's a big come up, bro. Whew. Eating. So now, as far as I know, to the best of my research, it has been sold to a company called VF Corporation. If I'm wrong, feel free to correct me down in the comment section. But this company owns, as far as I know, they own a lot of companies, right? But some of the bigger ones that I say that I'm familiar with, and I think that probably you all are probably familiar with, is Timberland. They own Vans, they own Dickies, and North Face. So as you can see, that's a lot of collaborations that they've done with Supreme already. Like Supreme, there's always a North Face like Supreme like collaboration, right? So it makes sense, right? Okay, so I guess finally the VF Corporation is like, hey, went on to make this investment. Most likely with Supreme being such a hype brand, I think it's safe to say they know they're gonna make they $2.1 billion back in no time. Now, what's the future for Supreme? I have no idea. Will things change? I have no idea. I mean, I would, if I had to guess, and this is just my opinion, I don't really see things really changing that much, because it's like Supreme is already a successful brand within itself. So it's like, honestly, that's a company where it's like, you really don't have to make too many changes. Of course, there's probably gonna be some changes. I don't know if they're gonna change designers or what, but I mean, they could just come in and just, you know, hey, we've been collaborating with you guys off rip. So it could have been something where it's like, we've been collaborating so much, it's to the point where it's like, bro, we might as well own it and just do everything off rip, keep all the original staff and just, you know what I mean? Cause really they just bought the owner out. You know what I'm saying? They could keep the original people, and pretty much we could probably never even notice that Supreme even switched, you know, a different owner. But usually when there's a new owner, usually things change, but I'm hoping not too much. The only thing my issue with Supreme is, not that I don't like Supreme, it's just that, I don't know, man, like their tees are nice, their clothing, and this is all opinion. I mean, if you disagree with me, it's cool. Y'all know I don't argue with nobody, because like I said, man, streetwear, sneaker clothing, it is all opinion based, right? Okay, so if you like something, cool. If I don't like it, cool. You know what I'm saying? That's what makes everybody like original, and everybody having their like own sense of style. Now, I do like some items on Supreme. I have some Supreme items. You guys know that if you go back on my channel and check that out. But I haven't copped any of it recently because honestly, man, it's just, some of that stuff is just a little too, it just, I don't like their fit per se to some of their items. But at the end of the day, man, if you come to my house like randomly, man, you'll see me in like a Supreme all white t-shirt, because y'all know I rock white tees all the time, right? Okay, but I just want to put the news out there and get you guys' opinion on it. What do you think the future of Supreme is now that it has a different owner? Do you think things are going to change the chain, stay the same, or do you think they're going to start to, like, I don't know, possibly we could see like them pushing the clothing brand like in stores, and it won't be as limited anymore. So I mean, either way, I think it's a win-win. Like at first, they're probably, if they do not make it as limited and they start putting it in malls and putting it in stores, like, you know, that stuff is gonna sell out probably in the beginning because everybody's not used to having that much access to such a rare brand. But then people will get comfortable to it, and then, you know, things will just be the same. But that's just my opinion. I want to know you guys' opinion. If you're even into Supreme to begin with, let me know down in the comment section, what are your thoughts and opinions on Supreme being sold to the VF Corporation for $2.1 billion. Anyway, man, I'm going to go on get up out of this thing and start rambling, man. Y'all be sure to hit that like button. It really helps the channel out. And if you're new, consider subscribing. I make content about sneakers. Again, my name is Jeremy Jones, and thank you for watching, and I'm out.
Man, I just woke up from a fat nap, so I'ma make raps in my room.